Hi everyone, welcome to my documentary. I am Jamie Roberta Bowden, and I am the daughter of Gloria and Joe Marshall. And I was adopted by my grandparents, who are Cammie and Marshall Bowden. And my dad Marshall, he died in 2014, January 27, 2014. And he was just an awesome man. We'll talk about him later on. But meanwhile, so I came to live here at this area known the Bowden Place, when I was a baby. When I first was given up for adoption. I am one of the shy ones. I'm actually shy. but over here, my granddaddy, Robert Bowden, great-granddaddy. Or is it great-great? No, it's great-granddaddy. Robert Bowden, who is the, Robert and Maddie Bowden, who is the parents of my dad that adopted me, Marsha Bowden. And they built this house behind me. In the late 50s, I think. In the 50s. So it's 2022. So it's a pretty old house now. And I ended up moving up here beside the house in 1996. My dad and his siblings gave me permission to live here, a lifelong journey to live here for as long as I live, and basically to help keep up the place and stuff. And so, like I said, this is the house now. It's gotten old, and basically became a storage home for some of the family members, and many people lived in this house. Lots of people lived in it. My daddy, his siblings, my grandparents. I remember Grandma Maddie when she lived in it. Very warm and cozy house. Had the wood stoves, nice rooms on the inside. I can't go in and give you a tour because the house is, it's went through some terrible times. These storms, as you can see, knocked off the gutters and stuff, the roof and all that. So, you know, it's not safe to go in there right now. But I decided to do this documentary for my great-grandchildren, my great-great-grandchildren, and those grandchildren that will come after that, my legacy, my generation. I want the generation that's coming behind me to know how important and valuable it is to stay in this family. And not to leave one hanging behind just because they don't think the same way, don't do the same things as one does. But know your place in the family. And so this just happened to fell into my lap as a caregiver of this property here. And it's coming with some challenges. But yeah, over to my side is the well. That well is over 100 years old, from what I was told by my dad. Before he passed, he did tell us a lot about these houses and stuff. This is an original. Original right here. I don't know if you can see. Yeah. That's an original house. This original house here was built in the 1800s. I want to say 1892. It's original. or either the 1900. It was close. It was close. It's very close. Not sure which one. I'm going to have to do some looking on the deeds to see. But this is part of the Bowden estate, which was originally Joe Banger's. Joe Banger, I think that's his name, Joe Banger, was the one guy who lived here, and he was the guy that actually gave my great-granddad the opportunity to purchase all of this land for his children, for his family. My great-granddaddy, Robert Bowden, he thought ahead of time, not just for himself, but he thought about his generation to come. He thought about his children. He knew one day his children would grow up, have children, and, you know, some would stay around, some would move off. Some of the other cousins and stuff have been down here. Some have been down here, and, you know, they come by and take pictures and stuff. One day I would love to fix it up and maybe have, like, a place where everybody could come and just make good times and remember the old times that were good and, you know, tell the stories of the good and the bad so that our next generation will know what's what. So, this house though, y'all, look at that. That's original wood. Original wood. That's amazing. Original bricks. Back when bricks were bricks. You see how pretty those bricks are? So it's very beautiful. And each house has its own well. Because back in the days, they, you know, they didn't have all these kind of requirements to put stuff in like they do now. This one has it right there in front of them. And it didn't have to be so many feet apart back then like it does now. Yeah, this is just part one of the journey. And as a caregiver of this property, it's a lot of work got to be done. I actually want to just ask family members if they would come down and help me to get it back restored. So that not just my children and grandchildren, but the heirs, there's over 100 heirs, and by now it's probably more than that, that are heirs to this property. And they left from here. I don't know why they left, but most of them that left saying that it was nothing here for them and that they wouldn't be back and just take care of it. And I just got it this year, June 21, 2022. I just got it where I could come and do stuff to it. I live here on the property, and that's one of the reasons why it was passed down to me as caregiver, because I do have a home on the property, not rich, no. And my thing is, if other family don't come and, you know, because we live in a new time, a new day. And if other family members don't come around and start showing interest in it, a place this large could easily get taken over. Not legally, but illegally. People could come and move in on the property and we not even know that they're here because it's such a large piece of property. So I'm praying that we're going to be able to bring some homes down through here soon. Make this a family home. Possibly even start a cemetery, you know. Possibly start a cemetery way to the back down there. I don't know, but it's beautiful. We will see. We'll see what God gives us to do. But meanwhile, y'all stay tuned for more about the Bowden property, the Bowden estate, how things will go, and to see if any of the family members are going to come down and put their two cents in. Might as well, family. Come on, family. All right, y'all. So hopefully I have more for you the next time I come on camera. It was just something God laid on my heart to do, was come on and tell a little bit about who I am. And maybe next time I come on, I will be able to give more detail. I'm a little out of breath today because I'm not feeling as good as I would like to feel. And that's one of my reasons why I wanted to make this video, because you just never know how your health is going to be. So don't wait to do stuff when you're in your bad health. Go ahead and get it done as soon as you can. And so this was my moment to get at least this little part out.